Yes, brother. Your name and your profession.
Yeah. Good evening, Mr. Zakir Naik. My name is Karan. And I'm a chartered accountant by profession. A few days back, I started viewing your lectures on YouTube. Firstly, I was very, very, you can say, irritated by the talks you give. But as and when I explored your more talks, so I was like 80 to 90% convinced what you say is right. And now I have a specific question on where Islam allows more than one marriage for a male. The reason which I found given by you is the number of females in the world is more than the males. So this is one of the reasons you gave. And I don't know whether it comes out of your logic or the logic of some other scholars or the logic given by the Quran. So I just want to clarify from where this logic has come.
Brother, mashallah, he has been seeing my lecture since a few months. Initially was irritated. Then he realized that 80-90% is right. I'm here to convince the balance 10-20%, inshallah, brother.
Thanks a lot.
He asked the question that when I said in my answer that why does Islam allow a man to have more than one wife? One of the reasons, as he rightly said, is that the female population is more than the male population. He's asking me, is it my logic or is it the logic of the Quran? The Quran doesn't mention the reason. The Quran is a telegraphic message. Sometimes it mentions the reason, sometimes it doesn't mention. For example, alcohol, it says, in it is more loss, less profit. The details are not given. In the Quran about marrying more than one wife, it's not mentioned because the female population more. It is my research, and from my research, I have analyzed that. But when you go on the net today, what you get the statistics today is not correct. For example, many statistics that you get in these ratio on the net is not correct. For example, it says that the population of Qatar, the men are 3 times more than female. I was shocked, how is it possible? Then I came to know, it is not the Qatari, many people, because the Qataris are so less, hardly about 150,000. There are many people from outside coming to work. And when most of the workers are male, so it is not the Qatar population, it is the Qatar mixed with expatriates. Okay. So everything what you find in the net may sometimes shock you, it is not correct. So when you do better research, you come to know. So as far as today's thing is concerned, there are more females in the world than the male. That's the reason, one of the reasons why polygamy is allowed, and there are other reasons given in my answer. Is there any question on that?
No, thanks, not on that.
So you only want to know, is it my reasoning or is it the Quran's reasoning?
Yeah, just that.
No, Quran says that, as you heard my talk, that one of the reasons is because the population of the female is more.
Right.
And the male population is less.
Yeah, right.
And if every man marries one woman, then there'll be many women who will not get husbands.
Right.
So the only option for them is either they marry a man who all day has a wife or become public property.
Right.
You know, you may say public property, it is a very harsh verse. It is the best verse I can think of. Like in USA alone, there are more than 4 million females more than male. In Russia alone, there are 10.3 million females more than male. If every man in Russia or in America marries a woman, yet there'll be 10.3 million in Russia and more than 4 million in USA who won't find husbands. So the only option remaining for them is that they either marry a man who already has a wife or become public property. But naturally, any modest woman would prefer marrying a man who already has a wife than become public property.
Okay.
Hope that answers the question.
Okay, thanks.
So now you're convinced. I would like to know from you, brother, which is the 10-20% you want more clarification on?
Actually, I'm convinced to an extent, if you take an interpretation out of the sacred books, then if I am a non-Muslim and if I read a Quran, so I will not get the same meaning if an Islamist read that.
No, it's not necessary.
So if we leave it to interpretation, then there may be the interpretation for other scriptures also.
No, interpretation is there, but it should not contradict the meaning. You cannot interpret with the wrong meaning. Find a person who has more knowledge. It's not necessary that a Muslim can interpret better than a non-Muslim. Keith Moore was a non-Muslim. Keith Moore, he's a non-Muslim. He interpreted the Quran better than the Muslims. What the Quran says in Surah Nahl chapter 16 verse 43 and Surah Anbiya chapter 21 verse number 7, Fas'alu ahl zikri in kuntum la ta'lamun. Ask the person who's an expert. So in embryology, he was an expert, a non-Muslim. His interpretation of embryology is far better than the Muslim because he's an expert. So to interpret the Quran, you have to go to the expert in that field. If the Quran speaks about fiqh, about luqa, then go to an Arabic expert. If the Quran speaks about science, go to a scientist. So in this example I gave in my talk, the non-Muslim scientists, they interpreted the Quran better. The same way, if you read the Quran, it's not necessary you don't understand. You may understand better than a Muslim. What I want to know, that which 10-20% you're not convinced about. So I will convince you on that also.
So that again, I'll come to your next session and inshallah, I will be convinced 100%.
Okay, very next. See, we don't know when next session will be there. See, what happens actually, we say inshallah, you're saying inshallah, that's good. Inshallah means God willing. You don't know how long you're going to live. So my next schedule to come is in March 2014, inshallah, when they have the peace convention, the third peace convention when they have in 2014, March or April. That will be my next public lecture, inshallah. But you don't know whether I will live till that time or not.
No, but we hope so.
We hope so, but now if you have any questions, then if you're convinced now, do you believe there's one God?
I believe in one God. I believe.
Do you believe Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God?
I don't 100% agree because I have not read the Quran.
So what I want you to do, read the Quran. Not that you have to read the Quran to understand about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I've even proved in my lecture from the Hindu scriptures. Have you heard my lecture on Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam Hindu scriptures?
Yes, I do. Yeah.
Yes, you have heard.
Yeah.
So from there I've proved about Kalki Avatar.
Yeah.
That in Kalki Avatar it speaks about a messenger to come, an avatar to come, whose father's name is Vishnu Yas. In Kalki Purana, chapter number 2, verse number 4, 5, 7, 9, 11, 15. It says, the father's name is Vishnu Yas. Vishnu means God, Yas means servant, servant of God. In Arabic, it's Abdullah, and Abdullah was the name of the father of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The mother's name is Sumati. Sumati means peace and serenity. In Arabic, it means Amina. The name of the mother of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is Amina. It says that he will have four companions, the four Khulafa Rashidin, Hazrat Abu Bakr, Hazrat Umar, Hazrat Usman, Hazrat Ali, the four companions. He got this revelation in night in a cave. And we know Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam got the first revelation in the night in the Gara Hira. He will migrate northwards and come back. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam migrated northward to Medina and came back. So all these prophecies, description about the final avatar to come according to the Hindu scripture, according to Kalki Avatar, according to Vedas, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the name of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is mentioned more than 100 places in the Hindu scriptures. If you read the Upanishads also, if you read the Puranas also, Bhavishya Purana, Parvatri, Khandatri, Adetatri, Shloka number 3-8, it talks about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Bhavishya Purana, Parvatri, Khandatri, Adetatri, Shloka number 8-27, it speaks about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So, have you seen this tape of mine?
Sorry, again?
Have you heard my lecture on Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, prophecy of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the Hindu scriptures? Have you heard that?
I have heard that. I have
So do you have any objection in that? Do you say that, no, this is not there in the scripture, this is not there in the Veda?
Okay, logical, on the face value, accept it, but I have to read my scripture first, then I can continue.
Okay, fine. So I request you that you read it as soon as possible. Don't wait till I come in March.
Okay.
If you are convinced in between, you can take Shahada with any Muslim. If you are not, then when I come, inshallah, we will meet again in March or April.
We'll
inshallah.
Meet. Yeah, sure. Okay. Thanks.